much and welcome to another hour of Georgia Championship Wrestling. We've got a lot of excitement coming up for you. First of all, let me bring in Roddy Piper, who obviously has some things on his mind this week.
It's going to be as simple as this. I ain't going to waste no time. Dusty Rhodes, Wahoo McDaniels, Tommy Rich, you're all playing big shot. You're all trying to do something. Well, you're going to understand what I mean by pay the Piper. The next 2 hours, you're going to see something you ain't never seen before. I ain't saying no more, man.
Okay, there you have it, the comments from one Roddy Piper. During the next hour, of course, we will be seeing the National Tag Team Champions in action. We'll be watching, and they'll be going up against, I might mention, Bob Armstrong and Kevin Sullivan. We're going to be seeing the National Heavyweight Champion Buzz Sawyer in action. We will be talking to the NWA World Heavyweight Wrestling Champion Ric Flair. And we're especially honored that in just a few moments, we will have on the program with us the mayor of the city of Atlanta, the Honorable Andrew Young. All of this is upcoming, a lot of great matches, so by all means do stay tuned. Right now, though, let's go to the ring for our first event. Brad Armstrong moving out against Pete Martin, one fall, 10-minute time limit. Martin in the black trunks. Brad Armstrong in the, teal blue, I guess, is about the best way to describe those trunks. Martin, 240 pounds, out of Montgomery, Alabama. Brad Armstrong, of course, a product of Marietta, Georgia. Good arm hook and takedown by Armstrong. Martin back on his feet, circles his man. Hiplock takedown by Brad Armstrong has Martin back to the canvas. And it is now the side headlock by Armstrong that keeps Martin in trouble now, back on their feet. And look at the strength of this man, Martin, as he tried to upend Armstrong. Armstrong countered beautifully and once again gets credit for the takedown. All right, Armstrong taking a bear hug there. Now, notice the way Martin came to the side of the rib cage. Good series of moves by Armstrong has Martin in trouble once again as Armstrong has gone to the hammerlock. Referee Scrappy McGowan watching him carefully. Duck under, go behind, reversal by Martin. But now look at Armstrong reversing that situation into a drop toe hold and then bars the arm. So Martin back to the canvas once again. All right, it is Brad Armstrong. Armstrong, necessarily cautious. Martin, an unknown quantity here. And so Armstrong is not going to rush into a situation with this man. He'll check him for his strength. He'll check him for power and balance, leverage. And also, all the time that this match is progressing, Brad Armstrong trying to analyze the man's approach, his attack, just exactly what he's facing in this opponent. And like Pete Martin, you don't have the opportunity, as you do in many other sports, to study all of your opponents closely before you go into the ring with them. And now it is Martin utilizing the ring ropes, forcing the break. Brad Armstrong, hands up, moves back. Nice, clean break. Martin, as you can see, bearing the marks of past matches. Drop toe hold by Brad Armstrong once again that puts Martin back to the canvas. Should be interesting, of course, as I said, the World Heavyweight Champion Ric Flair here today. The National Heavyweight Champion Buzz Sawyer. Big John Studd and the Super Destroyer, the National Tag Team Champions, and what an awesome combination they are. Big John Studd, about 6'7", over 300 pounds. You talk about a rugged individualist, he is indeed. Armstrong moved in very nicely that time into a good fireman carry takedown. Well executed. And it was Martin using the knee, and Armstrong very quickly uses his knee in retaliation, catches Martin in the biceps and in the triceps. So he has consistently been punishing Martin and has pretty generally stayed out front. Martin, on the other hand, could be quite possibly holding back just a little. Many times a competitor will allow you to move in, and the deeper you move in, the more trouble you get into, because suddenly you get yourself into a position when you've really gotten in tight with somebody, you'll suddenly find yourself in so close that you can't get out away from it. Look there, like Armstrong started to go for a fireman carry, saw that he had the leverage with the arm drag takedown, and reverted to that, scored effectively. Brad Armstrong maintains control. Now Martin, using his extra weight and strength, bulls Brad Armstrong back to the turnbuckle. Referee calls for the break, a clean break by Martin. Again, Martin could be trying to lull Armstrong into a sense of false security. Duck under, go behind. Waistlift takedown. Tried it once, it was partially blocked. Now, reverse Nelson hooks the far leg and moves in very quickly. Overhooks the head, back into an inside cradle. And again, Martin powers out, so Martin has been indeed holding back ever so slightly. Applying even more pressure now, back into the ring ropes. Double knee lift by Martin, and so Brad Armstrong may have been just exactly that, lulled a little bit by Martin, and now Martin, perhaps being both men colliding, and it's Armstrong coming off the better of the two as he appears to have a little more control of his faculties at this time. But it is Martin who perhaps thought that he had taken the very best that Armstrong had to offer, caught an inside cradle now, and again it is Martin powering out. Brad Armstrong moves in on him again very quickly. Armstrong with a drop toehold. And now it is Martin on the canvas, and Brad Armstrong drives the knee into the biceps, into the triceps once again. And so Brad Armstrong suddenly galvanized back into action here as Martin tried to explode on him. It was Brad Armstrong equal to that task and perhaps one step better, because now he definitely has Martin in trouble again on the canvas. Notice the way he has winged the arm. And Martin, grimacing in pain as he comes back to his feet. It is Brad Armstrong. Has him up. A full body slam on Pete Martin. So the man from Montgomery, Alabama, has it for himself. Brad Armstrong drives the knee into the chest of Martin. Again, Martin powers out. Great second effort here. Brad Armstrong caught him. Cross body block. Has him for the count of three. Brad Armstrong had him for the count of three, exercising a cross body block and scoring the pinfall.
Certainly with a great deal of pride and pleasure that we are privileged to have with us today a very, very distinguished guest. The gentleman who is with us is an ordained minister. He spent a decade with the late Dr. Martin Luther King as one of his very, very close associates. In 1972, he was elected to the U.S. Congress and served as a congressman from the 5th District here in Georgia until President Carter appointed him as the ambassador to the United Nations for the United States. And now he has accepted an even greater challenge. He is now the mayor of the city of Atlanta, and certainly a great pleasure that I introduce at this time the Honorable Andrew Young.
Mayor.
Mayor, you're bringing to the city of Atlanta really a new dimension. The fact that Atlanta is the gateway city to the South, and yet now you're bringing on international aspects due to your vast experience in international affairs.
Well, I tell you, we've had some very distinguished guests here. The Queen of Holland will be with us this week. The mayor of Los Angeles, Tom Bradley, was here last week. A former prime minister of Japan, minister of transportation from Nigeria, bankers and investors from Belgium and from Germany. And we're becoming truly an international city in our attempt to generate new job opportunities for all of our citizens, because we are going to have to expand our economy to generate new jobs to deal with our unemployment.
And, of course, that has become a major problem here in the United States right now. Mayor, I know that you're on a very, very tight schedule. You have a special reason for being here, so this time let me bring in the vice president of Georgia Championship Wrestling, Jerry Briscoe. Jerry?
Mayor Young, it's our pleasure to have you here on Georgia Championship Wrestling, and this great plaque that you have brought along is something that we behold to ourselves as a great honor.
Well, we want to thank you for the contribution that you make to our community, because you extend our community all over the nation, and Georgia wrestling is an international sport. As I've watched, I see you bring the best talent from all over the world here to Atlanta, and then project it around the world, and we're very grateful to you for your contributions to our community, Jerry.
Thank you very much, Mayor Young. And following your career, you've always been a battler and a winner at all times. And Mayor Young, people behind the scenes, such as our director, Skip Ellison, and Gordon Soley, and some of the wrestlers, Tommy Riches, all of the great wrestlers, all of them are battlers and performers, and they recognize you as a world leader, and they would like to perhaps thank you on through me, and thank you very much, Mayor.
As long as they don't throw me around that ring.
We'll see to it. Thank you, Mayor.
Thank you very much. The Honorable Andrew Young, Mayor of the City of Atlanta, and Jerry Briscoe, Vice President of the Georgia Championship Wrestling. We'll be back with more wrestling right after we pause for these words.
Every morning, people face the moment of truth. The moment they decide if their dishwasher detergent did the job.
If I find spots on these glasses.
Or didn't quite do the job.
I found spots on these glasses.
Try Cascade. Most detergents can leave drops that spot, but Cascade's sheeting action leaves glasses virtually spotless. Cascade's moment of truth.
What a shine! Now that's more like it.
Is Cascade's moment of glory.
I'm a beech nut nut, and I'm open-minded. I've tried other chews, but I always come back to beech nut. It's the honest tobacco taste. Don't burn. Not too sweet. Just right. Take it from me. I've tried them all. Still, I'm a beech nut nut!
Beech nut red and wintergreen.
Get ready, Columbus, Ohio. Georgia Championship Wrestling returns Sunday night, May the 30th, 8 p.m. to the Ohio Center. In tag team action, Ole Anderson and Roddy Piper face the team of Tommy Wildfire Rich and the American Dream Dusty Rose. Buzz Sawyer battles Kevin Sullivan. The Superstar meets Bad Bad Leroy Brown. Big John Studd faces Bob Armstrong. And the Super Destroyer meets Michael Hayes. That's Sunday night, May the 30th, 8 p.m., the Ohio Center. Tickets available at all select-a-seat outlets.
This week, Nashville Alive welcomes co-host Con Hunley. Also appearing, Kitty Wells, Diane Pfeiffer, and the Wilburn Brothers. Nashville Alive, tonight on Superstation WTBS. Glenn Hubbard and the Atlanta Braves collide with Gary Matthews and the Philadelphia Phillies Sunday afternoon at 2:05. Follow America's team on Superstation WTBS.
Well, it's certainly an honor to have the mayor of the city of Atlanta on Georgia Championship Wrestling. I have taken Jerry Briscoe aside once again. I want to talk a little further to Jerry about some problems that have been occurring. And as vice president of Georgia Championship Wrestling, I know you're beginning to address yourself to the problems concerning some of our competitors.
Well, Gordon, it's been quite a challenge taking on the position. We get fan mail throughout the entire United States and parts of Canada. And I'd like to add to that, we appreciate all the mail and all the input in there. Some of the things that are brought up are statements such as Roddy Piper or Ole Anderson, Stan Hansen making some of their actions in the ring. we're trying our best here at Georgia Championship Wrestling to clear up a lot of this. And I tell you one thing about Roddy Piper. He gets out here and he runs his mouth. He tells people how to wrestle, but he fails to do it inside the ring. And Gordon, you know as well as I do, that's where it counts. And as Piper would sign contracts, I'm sure that there would be a list of hundreds of wrestlers, qualified wrestlers, as he puts them, that would be more than happy to get in the ring against him. And I, myself, would take that opportunity to myself.
Well, now there's something that Mr. Piper can certainly cogitate on a bit, Jerry. Then it is a question of his just not signing contracts.
That's right, Gordon. All Mr. Piper has to do is sign some contracts, and he can get the worthy, qualified opponents that he's looking for.
Fair enough. Jerry Briscoe, Vice President of Georgia Championship Wrestling, and certainly, I guess, letting us all know at one time where these problems are and what is in the process of being done about them. We're waiting now for, well, there you hear it. The music is music of the Freebirds, and the original Freebird approaching the ring now, Michael Hayes, and we're set to go with our next match. Michael Hayes moving out there. He'll be going up against Mike Fair, and Fair now in the maroon and black trunks. Mike Hayes, of course, in the red and white with the stars, and it is Hayes facing a slightly heavier opponent. Good arm drag takedown. Collar and elbow once again. Do an arm drag takedown again. All right, it is an armbar now by Hayes as he keeps Mike Fair under as much control as possible. Hip toss by Michael Hayes. Hayes closes in once again very quickly. Uses Mike Fair, puts him into a full body slam. All right, Hayes back on his feet now. Fair watching his man. Once again, collar and elbow pulls Mike Hayes back to the far turnbuckle. Into an arm drag takedown now by Michael Hayes. Emotional conflicts in his career in professional wrestling, but one thing for sure, Michael Hayes has always been pretty much his own man, and even though there are times when I'm sure in reflection he may feel that he has done things that were perhaps not exactly according to Hoyle, nonetheless, I think at all times he has acted in what he believed to be the right thing. Fair pulls him back to that near turnbuckle now, and it is Fair trying to arm with him, and Hayes reverses that situation. Hayes moves in. Short clubbing hand into the stampede on Fair. Has him down for the three count. Has him down for the three count. And so Michael Hayes, the original Freebird, proving again his mettle in the ring. Let me take a moment right now to talk to a gentleman who certainly needs no introduction to wrestling fans the world over. I'm referring, of course, to former world heavyweight champion Tommy Wildfire Rich. And Tommy, well, you've been an extremely active man.
You know, Gordon, I just, you know, been doing a lot of thinking. Last Sunday at the Omni, I got my hand messed up, you know, and sometimes you forget about your upbringings and where you come from, you know, and I just got one thing I'd like to say to Piper and Ole Anderson. You know, a country boy can't survive, and ain't nobody sing it no better than Hank Williams. You know, a lot of times I get out here and holler and scream, but I know where I come from. You know, you tried to mess me up. You tried to break my hand. You didn't get the job done, Piper. You know, you stomped it. You sprained it. I went to the doctor. It's sprained. I've been soaking it. The doctor says I can wrestle. So y'all ain't stopped me, and ain't nobody going to stop me. So I'm going to keep chucking, I'm going to keep jabbing, and I'm going to keep going. And one of these days down the road, I'm going to get you. You've got a film of what they did, don't you, Gordon?
I do indeed. In fact, we want to take a look at that right now if we can. We can, at that time, also discuss what did happen to Tommy Wildfire Rich. We'll go back in time now to the Omni, and, of course, a tremendous crowd. But here's where the punishment began.
Well, see, Gordon, you forget it's supposed to be a sport wrestling. We got the three count on them, Dusty Rhodes and myself. We beat them 1, 2, 3. And then after it was over, I'd hurt my hand in the match. And then they took advantage of a situation right here, you know. And so that's where they can't take it, I guess. I don't understand.
Well, here, of course, you are in a tremendous amount of pain. And obviously, well, as you can see, Tommy has that hand well wrapped. He is under doctor's care. But you're back on the...
And I heard you say something about a country boy, and all your whole life, ever since you've been a little kid, Tommy Rich, you wanted to grow up to be a wrestler. Well, maybe you should have concentrated on growing up to be a man, you see, because I don't got to sit here and take this stuff from nobody, and you're lucky that I didn't break your arm. The only reason I didn't break your arm is because of kindness of my heart, Rich.
I
want
to tell you something. You're going to talk to me about a chance. You had the chance to do it last Sunday, and you didn't get the job done. Now ain't the time or the place.
Now ain't the time or the place. Well, let me tell you something. I would be happy to wrestle you anytime, anywhere, except that you bore me, Rich. There's nothing competition. Yes, you do. There's no competition for me from you. There's nothing. Your hands hurt. Here I step up.
Wait a second. Wow, boy, I'll tell you what. Roddy Piper, I think, went one step too far with Tommy Wildfire Rich. And we've got a fierce picture going here that you wouldn't believe. Michael Hayes just cut Ole Anderson off at the pass. Anderson trying to get in there now, and he's out of camera range. But I'll guarantee you this much, that Tommy Wildfire Rich has paid some dues and settled some dues right now. He's in an explosive situation. And I can't say that I blame Tommy Wildfire Rich at all.
Like I just said, a country boy can't survive.
Yeah, well, I'll guarantee you Tommy Wildfire Rich is a survivor. A 10-4 on that one, good buddy. We'll be right back.
As I promised at the beginning of the program, the National Heavyweight Champion, Buzz Sawyer, is with us.
You know, Mr. Soli, as you can see, and everybody out there in national TV can see, Buzz Sawyer is still the National Heavyweight Champion. I got the confidence, I got the belt, I got everything. And I'll tell you another thing, Tommy Rich and Dusty Rhodes, the Fantasia, the Freebird, watch out, because it's a different story now, it's a different situation. You got to beat me. I don't got to beat nobody.
Well, so maybe we'll see a difference in his methodology once he steps into the ring. We'll find out, because the National Heavyweight Champion, Buzz Sawyer, approaching the ring at this time, moving in. He's going up against Sonny Zane. One fall, 10-minute time limit. Beautiful series of moves by Sawyer. Into a drop toe hold and moved up on the body. Keeps the ride going and just and very quick, clean break by Sawyer. And so Sawyer, who has such a vast background, both in the amateur ranks as well as the pro ranks, had the distinction of watching Sawyer in his very first pro match, as a matter of fact. And there's no question in anybody's mind who watched him that he had a bright future in front of him. Part of that future now has been brought to culmination as he has achieved the National Heavyweight Championship. Tried to move on Zane. Zane. Here's the problems of Sawyer over him once again. Front face locking Zane, keeping him back to the canvas. Sawyer says they've got to come beat him now, but as you can tell by his aggressiveness, he is going to carry the fight to you. He is not defensive wrestler in that respect at all. He is a completely aggressive nature, and certainly shows it every time he steps into the ring. Notice the way Sawyer inclines the legs as well.
referee calls for the break. Sawyer steps back. Again, moving around. There, collar and elbow, and it is Zane pulling Sawyer backwards into the ropes. Referee calls for the break. And that time, Sawyer with those hands raised. Caught him in that borderline. Now Zane fires back. Sawyer retaliates with a forearm to the side of the jaw. Maintaining the pressure on Mr. Zane, trying to wear him down. Notice he keeps just constantly moving against his opponent. Of time, and of course, time is his ally. Zane would be an outstanding situation for him if he is able to pin Buzz Sawyer. I'm not sure that anybody could make Sawyer submit. I really am not sure about that. He is a man of such incredible strength and such great tenacity. Notice again the way he entwines the leg, you see, once again, stopping his opponent from making any effective moves to escape. Referee Scrappy McGowan checking those shoulders very carefully. And it is Sawyer. Sawyer right after him. Sawyer, wow, from a bear hug to a twisting, turning souffle. The count of three. The count of three, and it is all over for one Tony Zane, and Buzz Sawyer, the national heavyweight champion, emerges from yet another match, completely and unquestionably the victor in the event. Seeing it once again in slow motion, you'll see the way he hooks his man very nicely, has the arm trapped, the far leg trapped, and Zane, totally stunned, is down for the count of three, and it is all over. I'd like to remind you at this time, there will be wrestling this coming Tuesday in Adairsville, Georgia, on Thursday in Gadsden, Alabama, and on Friday in Gainesville, Georgia. So remember those dates now. Tuesday, Adairsville. Thursday, Gadsden, Alabama. And Friday in Gainesville. And, of course, Tommy Wildfire Rich very much in the thick of things.
Yes, sir. You know, Gordon, I'll be in all them towns. And we got a northern tour coming up again. I'm looking forward to doing, you know, going back up there. And just like I said, Piper, Ole Anderson, y'all are going to see a new Tommy Rich. A little low-key, a little settling down. I got a little pleasure then and enjoyed that a whole lot. But I ain't going to be out here hooping and hollering no more till I get the job done. You know, and we're going to Huntington, West Virginia. We're going to Columbus, Ohio. And somewhere down the road, you know, I'm going to get them, Gordon.
Well, in fact, here's a complete rundown.
Georgia Championship Wrestling is coming your way to Huntington, West Virginia, Saturday, May 29th. Match time is 8:30 p.m. In the Memorial Fieldhouse, you'll see such outstanding stars as Tommy Wildfire Rich, Michael Hayes, and many, many more. And then on Sunday, May 30th, 8 p.m., in Columbus, Ohio, at the Ohio Civic Center, you'll see Ole Anderson, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, Roddy Piper, and many more. And then Monday, June 7th, in Dayton, Ohio, at the Hera Arena. Tuesday, June 8th, in Canton, Ohio, at the Civic Center. Wednesday, June 9th, in Logan, West Virginia, at the Logan Fieldhouse. On Thursday, June 10th, Marion, Ohio at the Veterans Memorial Coliseum on Friday, June 11th in Charleston, West Virginia at the Civic Center. Remember, tickets are now available for the matches Saturday, May 29th in Huntington, West Virginia and Sunday, May 30th, 8 p.m. in Ohio at the Ohio Civic Center in Columbus. We'll see you. Georgia Championship Wrestling on tour and coming your way.
And two gentlemen will be coming your way, Bob Armstrong and Bad Bad Leroy Brown.
Exactly right, brother. We're northbound to get down. Georgia Championship Wrestling, Huntington, Columbus, Dayton, Canton, Charleston, West Virginia. We're going to be all points north. And I'm telling you something else. The National Tag Team Champions can be beat. They might be big, but they can be beat in any of these towns. It could happen. Me and Leroy will be on the scene watching for it.
Hey, Garden, he's talking about the two champion, Big John Studd, Super Destroyer. Hey, well, let me tell you something. They had them belts long enough. It's time for a change, Gordon. If you want anything to change, you got to do it for yourself. It might happen up north in Ohio. Me and Bob Armstrong, Super Destroyer, Superstar, Super Destroyer, Big John Studd. Get ready.
Amen. Together. Today's most requested love songs. Together. Two records that spotlight music's romantic side with Air Supply and Dan Hill. 20 of your favorite songs in this exclusive direct offer. Crystal Gale. Share something special with the one you love. The music of Quincy Jones. Melissa Manchester. Don McLean. The soft sounds of today's rock with Robert Johnson. Rita Coolidge. It's lifting me high. J.D. Souther. Dave Loggins. Music to be enjoyed alone or shared together. The Manhattans. And Dionne Warwick. Make someone happy tonight. Together.
Phone toll-free, 1-800-257-1234. In New Jersey, 800-232-6966. The Save COD Charger send check or money order for $9.98 for two LPs, $11.98 for 8-track or cassette, two together. P.O. Box 7500, Atlanta, Georgia, 30357. That's together. P.O. Box 7500, Atlanta, Georgia.
Tonight, dive into one of our last remaining frontiers, the undersea world of Jacques Cousteau. Tonight on Superstation WTBS.
Want to take a moment right now to talk to the NWA World Heavyweight Wrestling Champion, Ric Flair. And here's a man who the schedule he's keeping right now would put the average man 6 feet under in a hurry.
Well, let's be honest. Before we go another step further, let's be honest. Do I look any worse for wear? Now be honest, Gordon. Tan, you know, I'm going to sum it up like this. As I climbed aboard an Eastern Airliner today, two stewardesses standing at the door, tripping over their own feet, trying to get at me, I overheard one of them say,
"He really thinks he's something, doesn't he?" And she looked at her, excuse me, the other stewardess looked at the one who made the comment and said, "Darling, I think he knows he's something." That's Ric Flair. That sums up Ric Flair, the man. It sums up Ric Flair, the world champion. And now, unfinished business at hand. And I'm out here to watch a match between Leroy Brown and this goof right here. And then Leroy Brown and I got something to talk about after the match.
Fair enough. We can turn it to the ring at this particular time, then. It will be Ken Timms going up against Bad Bad Leroy Brown. Brown, of course, from the south side of Chicago.
And if we talk about Leroy Brown, how do you think he feels looking at me the way I am out here in all my magnificence, knowing that he's got to walk out here in coveralls, construction boots, a T-shirt, looking like a real clown, having to be in the presence of the world heavyweight champion?
Well, I would say one thing, of course, Leroy Brown is a very proud man indeed.
Come on, big boy.
Bad Leroy Brown stepping into that ring. And I can assure you of this, Mr. Flair, that regardless of what a man may follow as an occupant,
occupation or a profession. The thing is, I think everybody wants to be the very best at what they do.
Well, that's right. Now, you have just said the magic word, the very best. What am I holding in my hand, Mr. Foley?
At this moment, sir, the NWA World Heavyweight Championship.
Which would have to make me. That's right. Thank you very much. I couldn't have asked for anything more to come from a man that is as respected a professional wrestler as you are.
Bad Leroy Brown beginning to show why he wants to be indeed in the place of Ric Flair. As Tim's up in the air, a full body slam. Catches Tim's coming off the ropes. Uses that elbow effectively. Tim's down to the canvas, and bad Leroy Brown moving out, I think, with somewhat renewed vigor and determination, and has very much been the aggressor and the dominant force thus far in the match.
Well, there's no doubt about it. Hey, I'm not going to stand out here and try to tell you Leroy Brown is not a qualified professional wrestler. He's obviously one of the strongest men in professional wrestling. He obviously can overpower a punk like this guy is wrestling. But is he the caliber? Is he the man that Ric Flair is? Now, last week, he attempted to humiliate me out here. I was tired. I had jet lag. But today, brother, when he gets out of this ring, I got a little surprise for him.
Now, that should be interesting indeed.
All you worshippers of Ric Flair out there, stick around, because we're going to show Leroy Brown that he isn't as bad as he thinks he is.
Tim is back to the canvas once again as bad Leroy Brown has him up. A full body slam, and bad Leroy Brown off the ropes, crashes down across the chest. And a great.
All right, great. Leroy Brown scored an impressive victory. But now, hey, come here, big boy. Come here. Come here, big boy. Bring the camera over here.
All right.
I want to talk to you. Come on over here.
Well, Ric Flair wants to talk to Bad Leroy.
I said the NWA champ wants to talk to you. Come on.
Wait a minute.
Right there. You will notice. Read this one time, Gordon. Right there. What'd that say? Custom tailored for Ric Flair. Something the likes of which you have never seen in your entire life, brother. Take off the gold watch. I'm going to get ready this time, Daddy. We are wrestling again, in case you haven't figured it out. I said we are wrestling again, brother. The Nature Boy and Bad Leroy.
No. Gentlemen.
Hey, you don't want to be a small foot in front of your people, do you now? You show my kind of man you are, huh?
Well, all right. They're going to arm wrestle once again.
Boy, you're
going to
be mine. Come on.
Whoa, wait a minute. All right, are they going to arm wrestle? All right, gentlemen. Ready, set, go. All right, and what a test of strength between these two men right now. Leroy Brown and Ric Flair, the NWA World Heavyweight Champion. Both men straining mightily with everything they have, and bad Leroy Brown taking a slight edge at the moment now. Bad Leroy Brown having it, and Flair giving every bit of effort he has, and what a superhuman effort now as he's starting to take bad Leroy Brown over, but Brown fighting back, and Flair can. He's got him for a second time. Ric Flair defeated for a second time by bad Leroy Brown. He's got him.
I'll be back, brother. You have not seen the last of me.
Well, I'll tell you what. We have right now, we have a match that is in progress. No. Oh, all right, we know. Okay, well, we got a lot of things happening. We'll be back in just a moment. We'll be right back.
Impact Music Promotions presents the greatest collection of rock and roll ever. This is the All-American Pop Collection.
Two girls for every boy.
50 giant hits by the greatest names in American rock and roll in one super hit package, including...
A boyfriend's back and you're gonna be in trouble.
Feels like a raindrop falling from my eye.
It's my party and I'll cry if I want to. Cry if I want to. Cry if I want to. I can't stop myself from laughing.
There has never been an offer like this before. You get 50 of America's greatest rock hits by America's biggest rock and roll stars on 5 LPs, 5 8-track tapes, or 5 cassette tapes. The choice is yours, LP 8-track or cassette, but you pay only $19.95.
Come on, baby!
What
next?
Do next?
I fought the law and the law won. I fought the law and the law won.
Boom, 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 boom.
This American rock and roll library on 5 stereo LPs, 5 8-track or 5 cassette tapes. The choice is yours. 50 of America's biggest rock and roll hits, only $19.95. Now is the time to order.
To order, use your MasterCharge or Visa. Call toll-free 1-800-257-1234. In New Jersey, call 800-232-6966. Or save COD and handling charges by sending check or money order for $19.95 to American Pop Collection, Box 7500, Atlanta, Georgia.
Okay, we're going to see the National Tag Team Champions, Big John Studd and the Super Destroyer, in action here momentarily. And might just say that Studd and Slaughter, of course, Studd and Super Destroyer, rather, one Stud 6'9", and Super Destroyer is 6'4". So quite a tag team combination indeed. Now, are we going to that match now? I believe we are. And there you see them. Bob Armstrong and Kevin Sullivan. Bob Armstrong up against the Super Destroyer. Wow, good move by Bob Armstrong. The Super Destroyer utilized his weight that time, carried Armstrong back into the ring rope, but it was Armstrong who was ahead of him in aggressive moves.
Come on, go stay on the ground.
And some Checking those shoulders, tolls the count of three. It is all over. And, well, Bob Armstrong made the comment that the National Tag Team Champions could be beat, and by golly, they proved their point, because they certainly did do exactly that. They, in fact, defeated the National Tag Team Champions. Wrestling will be held this coming Tuesday in Adairsville, Georgia, next Thursday in Gadsden, Alabama, and next Friday in Gainesville, Georgia. And two men who are in the thick of things right now, Ole Anderson and Roddy Piper.
First of all, on June 6th, I want everybody to mark that down on your calendar. June 6th, because that's the big date for the Omni, and we've got a lot of surprises. Huntington on the 29th. All you people in Huntington, May 29th, you come on out, because you're going to see the greatest wrestling you've ever seen. And maybe you'll see an end to people like Tommy Rich and Dusty Rhodes. And on the 30th, Piper and I are going to team up, and we're going to have a chance to go to Columbus. Columbus is where it's happening on the 30th, Roddy. Quickly, come on.
And you think, Tommy Rich, that you're going to get away with nothing, that you're going to whip me? You will pay the price.
Georgia Championship Wrestling is coming your way to Huntington, West Virginia, Saturday, May 29th. Match time is 8:30 p.m. In the Memorial Fieldhouse, you'll see such outstanding stars as Tommy Wildfire Rich, Michael Hayes, and many, many more. And then on Sunday, May 30th, 8 p.m., in Columbus, Ohio, at the Ohio Civic Center, you'll see Ole Anderson, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, Roddy Piper, and many more. And then Monday, June 7th, in Dayton, Ohio, at the Hera Arena. Tuesday, June 8th, in Canton, Ohio, at the Civic Center. Wednesday, June 9th, in Logan, West Virginia, at the Logan Fieldhouse. On Thursday, June 10th, Marion, Ohio, at the Veterans Memorial Coliseum. On Friday, June 11th, in Charleston, West Virginia, at the Civic Center. Remember, tickets are now available for the matches Saturday, May 29th, in Huntington, West Virginia, and Sunday, May 30th, 8 p.m., in Ohio, at the Ohio Civic Center in Columbus. We'll see you. Georgia Championship Wrestling on tour and coming your way. And the superstar is another man who's a man on the move.
I'm going to be on the move. I'm going to be in Canton. I'm going to be in Logan. I'm going to be in Charleston. I'm going to also be in Huntington and Columbus. And I hear Tommy Rich out here, Mr. Low Key, Mr. Humble, Mr. Country Boy. All of a sudden, maybe because you had the wind knocked out of your sails. Leroy Brown's riding high. Big, tough arm wrestler. Bob Armstrong and Kevin Sullivan spouting off again. There's going to be a lot of excitement. There are going to be some changes, I'm sure, because things happen back and forth. I'm going to be in the middle of all these changes. I'm the individual who used to rule this area. I used to be the champion. I really don't like the name of former champion. So whether it be in Dayton or Canton or Logan or Charleston or Marion, Ohio or Huntington or Columbus, it really doesn't matter. Put your name on the contract, fellas, and I'll be in the ring.
We'll be back. There's the bell, the final match in this hour of Georgia Championship Wrestling. One fall, television time remaining. David Jones in the yellow trunks, moving against the superstar. And the superstar who has said that he does not care to be introduced or thought of as a former champion, and fully intends to do something about that in regaining some titles. Here's a man who has been a dominant force in professional wrestling for some time. Has quite a background, quite a career. Holds his master's degree. He is formerly in the amateur ranks, an outstanding athlete, and just about any sport you want to name, this man can excel. He just has a great, great ability in all respects. and pace locking once again has Jones back to the canvas. Referee, quick check to make sure he was not choking, back into the ring ropes once again. Overhook the manner in which he has. Once again, a quick takedown from a lateral drop. Jones powering out before the count. Front chancery now by the superstar. You know, when you stop to think about the size of the men in professional wrestling today, men like the superstar, the super destroyer, Big John Studd, Andre the Giant, I put them all in that category of being such a tremendously big, powerful man. You stop to think of a man like David Jones, who's just a shade over 6 feet tall, battling back. And can almost appear to be slightly diminutive in front of somebody as large as the superstar. But then again, you get such powerhouses of men who are not quite as tall, but are great, great competitors. Kevin Sullivan, Buzz Sawyer. Just outstanding competitors. A truly universal sport, and once again, now it is the superstar. Overhooking the head has Jones back to the canvas again. The superstar has carried the battle of Jones. Jones tried a moment ago to retaliate. Did not have any appreciable effect on the superstar. Once again, the referee scrapped from the gown, checking, making sure there's no choke involved. A drive by the superstar to the midsection and catches him in the arm. And it is Jones outside the ring on the concrete floor. And now caught with the flat of the foot to the side of the head, and Jones has more than a handful of problems here. Jones still outside the ring. Referee continues to toll the count. Jones back into the ring now, and it is the superstar again closing in on him. Off the ropes. Caught him with a lariat. Almost tore his head off. Jones trying to crawl away from it. Could not. The count of three. It is all over. And so David Jones goes down in defeat to the superstar. And Roddy Piper has joined me once again.
Yeah. Roddy Piper. You see Tommy Young, Tommy Rich, Jack Briscoe, all kinds of wrestlers are riding real high right now. Tommy Rich snatches me when I'm coming out here being a man, takes me, throws me in the ring, catches me off guard, and thinks he's some kind of big wig. Everybody's riding real big right now, aren't they? Well, let me tell you something. I'm going to talk soft and quiet, and I'm going to use real simple little words so you can understand me. Before this hour is out, Mr. Rich, you and I are going to have a confrontation. Before this hour is out, Mr. Rich, I am going to go into the parking lot. I am going to go into the studio. I have Mr. Sawyer right here.
That's
and
it.
Before this hour is out, I have the superstar. I'm talking about gang war, brother.
We're talking about Columbus, Ohio, Kevin Sullivan, and Huntington, West Virginia, Tommy Rich. By the time we're all done with you, you're not even have to worry about it. We're going to put you down. One, two, three.
As the song said, there's going to be some changes made. Right here in Huntington, West Virginia, Columbus, Ohio, Leroy Brown, Big Mouth Tommy Rich. It's all going to come to an end. You just wait and see.
The announcers on this program are employed by Georgia Championship Wrestling Incorporated. Coming up next on WTBS, more of Georgia Championship Wrestling, followed by an hour of country western music on Nashville Alive. Then stay tuned for the undersea world of Jacques Cousteau, followed by the TBS Weekend News, here on Superstation WTBS.
Welcome to another hour of Georgia Championship Wrestling. I'm Gordon Soley, your host, and right now let me bring in a man who is really in the center of the sea of a storm right now, Roddy Piper.
Yes, a storm. You see, when stopping Roddy Piper is like trying to save the Titanic with a cork, you see. You're talking about Dusty Rhodes thinking he's some kind of big shot. Tommy Rich, well, let me tell you something. I am going to quit talking. I am going to quit saying things. I got a man, mindless, heedless shark. You want to bring out animals like you did, Rhodes? Well, I got something for you, Rhodes Rich, this hour right now, brother. You watch your back because you're going to find out that I'm a master.
Well, indeed. Okay, Roddy Piper. Next week, Terry Gordy will be here on Georgia Championship Wrestling. During this hour, of course, we will be hearing from the mayor of the city of Atlanta, the Honorable Andrew Young. We'll also be seeing the national heavyweight champion Buzz Sawyer, Ray Stevens, Chick Donovan coming up. Some newcomers, the Samoans, a whole lot of great action upcoming. Right now, let's go to the ring for our first match. And we'll be pitting Pete Martin going up against Tom Pritchard. Pritchard, as we told you last week, has quite an impressive background, including a black belt in karate. He has been an instructor. He's in there right now, Nick Patrick, the referee. Nick is, by the way, the referee, a stalwart young man who's now pressing about 350 pounds. So he's moving up and bulking up extremely well. Pritchard, by the way, as you saw there, good block by Pritchard. Martin tried to bring him up and tried to disengage him, but Pritchard hung in there, has the takedown, keeps the side headlock. Pritchard is not one for vocalizing very much, but he does it extremely well in the ring. His actions certainly speak for him. Martin trying very, very hard to escape now from that side headlock and showing great strength here. The outside, Pritchard now trying to keep him tied up, and Martin trying to turn the edge to his own favor here, but Pritchard getting that leverage brings Martin back into the side headlock. Good takedown, and look at the way Pritchard very quickly has him in a half Nelson here now. It is now changing his attack. Goes now to a loose ride around the waist. Pritchard keeps the ride going. Martin tries to get back to his feet, does so. And now it'll be Martin, a standing reverse. Good move by Martin. And Pritchard with a standing reverse. And so, and from there, a waist lift takedown. Of course, once those feet leave the mat, you then become subject to whatever your competitor wants to do. And in that case, a good high waist lift takedown took him back to the canvas. Partial Nelson out of the armbar. All right, Pritchard keeps the pressure on Martin. Martin, full arm dragon twist by Pritchard. Good wide step over. Blown over into a takedown. Good move by Pritchard. However, too close to the ropes, and so it is Martin forcing the break. He was into the ropes. Pritchard moves exceptionally fast. Pritchard, good fireman carry takedown. Martin's arms and legs flailing, but to no avail as Pritchard maintained the takedown. Goes to an inside armbar, has the knee across the side of the jaw of Martin. Martin has been on the receiving end thus far in the match. It has been Pritchard who's been carrying the match. Martin now pulls Pritchard. And almost got to Pritchard that time. Psychological warfare here, and Pritchard almost went for it. Almost exploded in anger. That's what exactly what Martin was looking for, is to get Pritchard to make a mistake. Hey, Nick Patrick warning Pritchard about the use of the fist and also warning Martin now about his tactics. A circle in, drop goal by Tom Pritchard puts Martin back to the canvas. Wide stance. Good move that time as he broke it up. Caught Pritchard in a snapmare. Pritchard retaliates very quickly. The long dragon twist then down across the arm. So Martin now tries to get him in a scissors and does. He breaks it up. Pritchard powers out. And Pritchard now frustrated when he suddenly discovers this man, Martin, is perhaps more resourceful than he had imagined. Arm drag and twist once again. This time it's Martin retaliating. Kip up by Pritchard. Pritchard very quickly. New an arm drag twist and quick takedown on Martin. One can only say, and I certainly hope that all people concerned are not taking the comments by one Roddy Piper very lightly. Rod Piper is an interesting individual. And I would say one thing, however, that he is not the kind of man in the brief span of time that I've known him to make comments lightly, nor to make idle threats. So I would certainly hope that the people in question are watching this man very, very carefully. Pritchard caught, knee to the midsection once again by Martin. Martin brings him out, has him up. Full body slam on Pritchard. And again, it is Martin administering more punishment. Full body slam again by Martin, and for the first time in this match, Martin has very definitely become the aggressive. And that time, as he came down with the elbows, Pritchard rolling off to one side. Pritchard now quickly retaliating as Martin as now taking one to the side of the head that rocks him, and Pritchard swing off the ropes. There's some of the karate training coming out, and now Pritchard down across the chest into a lateral press. Count of three. A count of three. It is all over, and so the victor in this match, wearing the blue trunks, Tom Pritchard.
Certainly with a great deal of pride and pleasure that we are privileged to have with us today a very, very distinguished guest. The gentleman who is with us is an ordained minister. He spent a decade with the late Dr. Martin Luther King as one of his very, very close associates. In 1972, he was elected to the U.S. Congress and served as a congressman from the 5th District here in Georgia until President Carter appointed him as the ambassador to the United Nations for the United States. And now he has accepted an even greater challenge. He is now the mayor of the city of Atlanta, and certainly a great pleasure that I introduce at this time the Honorable Andrew Young.
Mayor.
Mayor, you're bringing to the city of Atlanta really a new dimension. The fact that Atlanta is the gateway city to the South. And yet now you're bringing on international aspects due to your vast experience in international affairs.
Well, I tell you, we've had some very distinguished guests here. The Queen of Holland will be with us this week. The mayor of Los Angeles, Tom Bradley, was here last week. A former prime minister of Japan, minister of transportation from Nigeria, bankers and investors from Belgium and from Germany. And we're becoming truly an international city in our attempt to generate new job opportunities for all of our citizens, because we are going to have to expand our economy to generate new jobs to deal with our unemployment.
And, of course, that has become a major problem here in the United States right now. Mayor, I know that you're on a very, very tight schedule. You have a special reason for being here, so this time let me bring in the vice president of Georgia Championship Wrestling, Jerry Briscoe. Jerry?
Mayor Young, it's our pleasure to have you here on Georgia Championship Wrestling, and
this great plaque that you have brought along is something that we behold to ourselves as a great honor.
Well, we want to thank you for the contribution that you make to our community, because you extend our community all over the nation, and Georgia wrestling is an international sport. As I've watched, I see you bring the best talent from all over the world here to Atlanta, and then project it around the world, and we're very grateful to you for your contributions to our community, Jerry.
Thank you very much, Mayor Young. And following your career, you've always been a battler and a winner at all times, and Mayor Young, people behind the scenes, such as our director, Skip Ellison, and Gordon Soley, and some of the wrestlers, Tommy Riches, all of the great wrestlers, all of them are battlers and performers, and they recognize you as a world leader, and they would like to perhaps thank you on through me, and thank you very much, Mayor.
As long as they don't throw me around that ring.
We'll see to it. Thank you, Mayor.
Thank you very much. The Honorable Andrew Young, Mayor of the City of Atlanta, and Jerry Briscoe, Vice President of the Georgia Championship Wrestling. We'll be back with more wrestling right after we pause for these words. You're about to discover how good real moisture tastes in a chewing tobacco that stands alone. Taylor's Pride, the genuinely moist chewing tobacco. Taylor's Pride is made from hand-selected tobaccos and the choicest flavorings, all wrapped up in a resealable foil pouch to preserve that moist, mild flavor. Now, taste the genuinely moist chewing tobacco. Taylor's Pride.
Imperial House presents the best of Creedence Clearwater Revival, destined to become a collector's edition. This is original CCR. Original CCR, there's never been an album like it. For the first time on television, the greatest original hits of Creedence Clearwater Revival. Order now and hear the music that changed the face of rock and roll. Creedence Clearwater Revival is only available in this limited TV offer from Imperial House. Here's how to order yours.
Phone toll-free 1-800-257-1234. In New Jersey, 800-232-6966. Save COD charges. Send check or money order for 798 for LP, 998 for 8-track or cassette. The Creedence Clearwater Revival, P.O. Box 7500, Atlanta, Georgia, 30357.
I'm standing between the National Tag Team Champions to my immediate right, Big John the Grizzly Stud, and to my left, the Super Destroyer.
You know, people out there have been taking us for granted. They're thinking we're a couple of nice guys. Well, we have talked it over, and we're going to turn over a new leaf. From this day forth, we're going to go in that ring with one thing in mind, two things. That's to hold our National Heavyweight Tag Championship, and that's to hurt our opponents. So all you big shots, all you big guns, you come looking for us, and that's what you're going to find.
You know, people have been avoiding us. John Studd and I thought that we got these belts. All the big names in the wrestling world would be coming after us, but it seems they're afraid of us. Now, John Studd and I, we're going to make things happen. We're going to start making things happen our way, and John Studd and the Super Destroyer are going to have it our way from now on.
Thank you very much, gentlemen. The National Tag Team Champion standing between those two can make somebody of my size have the world's largest inferiority complex. I can assure you of that. Let's go to the ring. Super Destroyer and John the Grizzly Stud facing David Jones and El Mongol. Now, with El Mongol, we have watched him in action the past several weeks. As said before, a man. There you see it. The efficiency that this man has regarding his sport is absolutely phenomenal. And it is Super Destroyer trying to get some extra leverage as the Mongol slipped away from him and caught him in the throat. Super Destroyer watching him carefully. One fall, 10-minute time limit on Australian tag team. He missed again, and Mongo caught him once again. Well, Mongo using everything at his disposal, and now Big John Studd steps over the top rope. Catching him once again, Big John Studd, using those massive forearms as battering rams, and is the Mongol catching him with a chop to the head, and Studd looking at this man, obviously with newfound respect. Studd staggered backwards momentarily, and now faces David Jones. Jones. And Studd has him up against the rope, crashes down across his chest. Ah, hip toss. Super Destroyer tags up, moves into the ring. Full body slam. Jones into the turnbuckle, and Jones's vertebrae taking a lot of beating here. And again, the Super Destroyer using the forearm across the thoracic region of the back. Big John Studd now with a boot to the midsection. Jones fires to the midsection, but those are out. Studd took everything Jones had to offer and then came right back after him. And again, he drives Jones. They're concentrating on the back of Jones. Super Destroyer makes the tag, moves back in, and again, going after the spine. Now the bear hug down around the base of the rib cage. Jones battling his way, trying to fire out if he can, but. Thus far, unable to do so as the Super Destroyer catches him once again. The tag is made. Big John Studd caught him with an elbow coming off the ropes. That's better than 330 pounds of Big Bad Big John Studd. 6'9". Brings him up, down into a backbreaker. To the midsection once again. And a bear hug here. Wow, to a full slam, power slam if you will. Count of three, count of three. We may be able to see that again, but he did. He utilized a power slam into a pinning combination with great efficiency. Watch now. Jones fires to the midsection. Now watch the Super Destroyer in total control as Jones tried to move on. Look at this. Super Destroyer picking him up bodily, has him in the bear hug, then suddenly turning into his man, powers him right down into the canvas for the count of three, and it is all over. One, two, three, and the National Tag Team Champions emerge victorious once again. Would like to mention that we'll be wrestling tomorrow night in Marietta at the Cobb County Civic Center, an outstanding night of wrestling competition. Next Tuesday in Adairsville, Georgia. Next Thursday in Gadsden, Alabama. Next Friday in Gainesville, Georgia. And, of course, the Omni, where wrestling action returns there on June 6th. And these two men obviously are looking for something now called the National Tag Team Championship.
That's right. You might call it an upset, but we came to win, and we proved once again it's not the size of the man in the fight, it's the size of the fight and the man, right? The man
no
in the fight don't
question.
Have to be big, right?
Exactly.
Tell him, Kel.
Well, you know, besides that, I have this thing with the national champion, Buzz Sawyer. You know, I don't think he's the national champion because I defeated him. And there's a new doll, a Buzz Sawyer doll. I'm a coward. I'm a coward. There it is right there. He's a chicken, and I'm going to get him.
Well,
Buzz Sawyer.
It looks just like Buzz. It even got the hole in the head just like Buzz Sawyer.
Georgia Championship Wrestling is coming your way to Huntington, West Virginia, Saturday, May 29th. Match time is 8:30 p.m. In the Memorial Fieldhouse, you'll see such outstanding stars as Tommy Wildfire Rich, Michael Hayes, and many, many more. And then on Sunday, May 30th, 8 p.m., in Columbus, Ohio, at the Ohio Civic Center, you'll see Ole Anderson, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, Roddy Piper, and many more. And then Monday, June 7th, in Dayton, Ohio, at the Hera Arena. Tuesday, June 8th, in Canton, Ohio, at the Civic Center. Wednesday, June 9th, in Logan, West Virginia, at the Logan Fieldhouse. On Thursday, June 10th, Marion, Ohio, at the Veterans Memorial Coliseum. On Friday, June 11th, in Charleston, West Virginia, at the Civic Center. Remember, tickets are now available for the matches Saturday, May 29th, in Huntington, West Virginia, and Sunday, May 30th, 8 p.m., in Ohio, at the Ohio Civic Center in Columbus. We'll see you. Georgia Championship Wrestling on tour and coming your way. Okay, I want to take a moment now to talk to both Tommy Wildfire Rich and Michael Hayes.
You know, it's just like I said, going to Country Boy Can't Survive, and in Huntington, West Virginia, Columbus, Ohio, you know, there's a lot of coal miners and stuff up through there, and I'd just like to say, we're going to get a Holt of Piper down through there.
Hey, he said it all, baby. Piper, you are a marked man, brother. Your time is coming because the plan has already been set down. He's talking about gang wars. Well, baby, I've been running with gangs all my life, and that sounds right up my alley. So here we come, back up like Bob Armstrong said, northbound and down, baby.
There you go. You'll see them in action, and don't forget the Omni on the 6th. Sawyer, National Heavyweight Champion, outside the ring wearing the National Heavyweight Championship belt. He's about to go up against Vince Tapparello. And so Sawyer now steps through the ropes. The referee very quickly calls for the bell. Tapparello has a height advantage here. And Sawyer, you can see tremendous strength in Sawyer. Absolutely exploding on that man. Catches him from behind, drives him to the canvas. And now maintains a ride on him. Tapparello trying to escape, and it is Sawyer just keeping him totally dominated at this point in time. And Tommy Wildfire Richards joined me.
Come out here and watch this bus. So, you know, he beat me for the national heavyweight title. You know, I ain't taking nothing away from you. He takes these guys out here. You know, everybody starts somewhere. And it's like these younger guys he takes. And, you know, it's one thing to go out there and wrestle a guy and make it a sport. You know, he goes out there and takes advantage of them and tries to hurt them bad, you know. And, like, when I started in Memphis, I used to get my tail whipped every time I got in the ring. You know, and you start learning. But, you know, it's a thing when you go out there and take advantage of a guy and you go out there and wrestle him to beat him because this is supposed to be a sport, you know.
Full slam by Sawyer, and Sawyer seems to delight in causing as much pain and agony on an opponent as he can. And it is...
See, right there, Gordon, you know, he comes from a wrestling background. That's not wrestling right there. And there's no use in taking a young guy in there that's just starting, just learning, and abusing him right there.
Tapparello down once again, and Sawyer now brings him up over that top rope. Tapparello able to block it partially. Came down across the chest.
Yeah. It's real tough, Gordon. It takes a lot of man to get a guy in there and take advantage of him like that.
High double knee lift by Sawyer. And now Sawyer just is solid. And it is Tapparello firing in the midsection. And Tapparello's upper body has been reddened considerably by this punishment.
Kidding, Gordon. You hit on that concrete enough, it messes you back up, you know. And that's what messes a lot of guys up.
Forearm across the chest once again by Sawyer, and Sawyer now drives the feet into the stomach of Tafarello, and Tafarello's face wreathed in agony now as he's trying to get back to his feet. You have to give him a lot of credit for having a lot of courage, Tommy.
That's exactly right, you know, that's the thing. A lot of these guys, they got the heart and desire to get a guy like Buzz Sawyer. You don't have no mercy. It's just like I said, Gordon, it's a sport. His mouth's busted now, you know, he's busted his mouth. It's a little ridiculous.
Tafarello drives a shoulder and drops Sawyer to the canvas.
Where is he going?
No, sir. He's a gritty competitor in Tafarello. Now beginning to explode on Sawyer, and Sawyer retaliating. And Tafarello does not have at this point the lasting power because of the punishment that he has already taken. Sawyer has him up. Belly to back suplex. And now it is Tafarello in a lot of trouble.
Yeah, boy, it looked like he did it then.
Got him down one. Oh, no, he didn't even allow the pin. And it was obvious to me, I think, Tommy, this man, Tafarello, is all but out.
Right there, you know, it's just, you know, sportsmanship. Look at that, see? See, now he's trying to hurt the guy. It ain't that he's just trying to...
And again, did not allow the pin.
That's what he's talking about, sportsmanship. See, he's got the guy beaten. Now he's not doing nothing but humiliating the guy now.
Well, I certainly have to agree with you there, Tommy. He's got the man. The man is completely demolished. And again, now... and again, did not allow the pin. And the referee totally... wildfires exploded on Buzz Sawyer. Referee calls for the bell here. Tommy Wildfire Rich taking all of that he could take.
slightly heavier opponent, and good drop toehold by Donovan, and floats over his man, and now has him in a front chancery. So Donovan moving very positive, very aggressively. Zane trying to come out of it now, and it's Donovan. Good series of move to escape. Donovan punishing Zane, caught him with a forearm that time, and now Donovan, of course, keeps himself, as you can see, in the peak of physical condition, facing a man who is slightly taller and perhaps slightly heavier, and a test of strength here between these two, and Donovan coming out the victor there. Full arm dragon twist once again. Zane now trying to come out. Does, and Zane turns the tide on Chick Donovan. Donovan very quickly retaliates. Another reversal by Donovan. All right. Donovan to his man once again. Interesting match, pitting two fine athletes against each other. Donovan, of course, we've had the opportunity of seeing many times here on Georgia Championship Wrestling. Zane, a relative newcomer. And Donovan again, some more punishment up to the deltoid muscle area. Donovan now, variation of a snapmare, then down across the arm. So Donovan is now pretty solidly concentrating on the left arm of Zane, keeping more and more pressure on that left arm. And again, Donovan trying to take away a point of balance and a point of attack from Zane. Inside, sort of a variation of an inside step over on the arm by Donovan. All right, Zane up into those ropes now. Donovan fires him off. Good move by Zane, but they're into the ropes. Into the ropes, and Donovan now beginning to punish Zane very quickly as he was almost upended and pinned that time. Donovan now scores with a good solid forearm to the side of the head. And Zane comes back to his feet. It's Donovan smashing Zane into the turnbuckle. And so now Donovan, I said, almost embarrassed there. Had him up full body slam by Donovan. Donovan down across the throat of Zane to a lateral press. Zane powers out before the count of three. Again, a snapmare. And it's Donovan in behind his man. A rear chin lock on Zane. All right, it is Donovan keeping total pressure there and dangerously close to a possible choke area. You heard the referee double-checking and see the referee checking again that forearm to see if it's if it comes across the air passage of the throat, then, of course, it, the hold must be broken. But Donovan was careful. And now Donovan with forearms. Zane trying to fire back, and Donovan brings him up. Quick snapmare once again to the rear chin lock. Donovan still keeping the pressure. Zane is going to have to try and figure a new attack or a new approach on Donovan. Donovan off the ropes, caught, full body slam, and it was Zane trying for a pinfall on Chick. Donovan moves in on Donovan once again, and so Zane, great second effort here. That time it was Donovan, caught him, vertical body block coming in. No, sir.
He got the shoulder off, and it's Donovan bringing him up full slam once again. Donovan closing in on him once again. Zane coming up slowly. Donovan caught him. Good drop kick coming off the ropes. And Donovan moves in again. Uses a variation of the neck breaker. Quick float over. Has a three count. Has a three count as he hooked that far leg. And so Chick Donovan scoring certainly a well-deserved victory here on Georgia Championship Wrestling. A fine athlete, and there you can see him obviously very pleased with that victory in a tough battle all the way. I've called for, and he is now with us, Jerry Briscoe, the vice president of Georgia Championship Wrestling. Any word on Tommy Rich?
Well, as you know, Tommy Rich is a close friend of mine. I've been with him. And Gordon, right now there is no movement in his fingers whatsoever. They're rushing him to the hospital for medical attention at this point. You know, something's got to be done. When you're a finely tuned athlete such as Tommy Rich, even Roddy Piper, Ole Anderson, or Stan Hansen, you walk that line of being on one side or the other. You know, you've got instances like when the bean ball is thrown. Is a bean ball actually thrown at a batter on purpose, or is it an accident? Or if you see two football players over on the side fighting, these people are professional athletes. They're honed up, they're peaked up, they're in top shape mentally and physically, and sometimes, Gordon, things happen, and I tell you, sometimes it carried a little bit too far, and as the old saying goes, one of these days the table's going to get reversed on Piper, Anderson, Superstars, Destroyers, and all the rest of them, Gordon.
Well, you know, Jerry, I have to believe that the situation here, when it presented itself, almost became a situation of premeditation on the part of Roddy Piper. He made the statement that he would get to Tommy Wildfire Rich. He obviously did. I know for a fact that you, too, have had your problems with this man, Piper.
Well, let me say this about Tommy Rich first. Whether he's got a broken hand, all five fingers broken, every bone in his arm broken, Tommy Rich has the permission of Georgia Championship Wrestling to put the heaviest cast on there that he wants and be able to compete tonight, any other night that he wants, with that cast on there against Piper. And speaking of Piper, as you said, Gordon, Roddy Piper and I, we have had our differences. I've tried to conduct myself. I've been able to become vice president of Georgia Championship Wrestling, take myself out of active wrestling. But Piper, you keep throwing yourself in. I'm trying. We'll see something here, Gordon.
Well, let's do this. Let's go to Charlotte, North Carolina, in a situation that occurred not too terribly long ago with Jerry Briscoe and this man, Roddy Piper. And I think it points up exactly what we're talking about, although certainly we could have no more graphic illustration than what we saw a few moments ago with Tommy Wildfire Rich. But if we can, let's move on. And, of course, you were in a single match that had nothing to do with Roddy Piper.
Well, that's right. My opponent here, he had a partner. My brother Jack and I were scheduled to go tag team. Here you see, I've got the figure four leg lock on him. He has conceded the match here. You see referee Sonny Fargo calling for the bell here. He's asking him if he gives up. He calls for the bell. Then out of nowhere, Piper, you see here he comes across. Figure four leg lock. We're both locked into the position. The other man that I'm wrestling is out of wrestling. They don't know if he'll ever be able to come back. Severely tore his ligaments in it. Broke the small femur bone in his leg. My leg, as you know, Gordon, I've had several knee problems in the past. Fortunately, my knee is a little bit better, but it's still a little stiff. Piper, one of these days, somebody is going to sneak up on you in that ring when you least expect it. And it's not going to be saying, smile. It's going to be saying, you're hurt, Mr. Piper.
It may just well be a man with a rather large cast on his arm, if that's what it calls for. We'll be right back.
That's Glenn Campbell. Hi, I'm Ralph Emery from WSMV in Nashville. You know, I've been around country music all my life, but there's a new album by Sessions that's just about the finest country album I've ever seen. 50 Original Country Hits contains 50 of country music's greatest hits, performed by country stars like Don Williams. Some broken heart. Barbara Mandrell.
But not to each other.
I'll
get over you.
Crystal Gayle.
Big wheels rolling.
Merle Haggard.
Big wheels rolling, moving on. And if love was a climb, the climb would be trying to find.
Tommy Overstreet.
It's fast, the horses. Younger women.
Tom T. Hall.
Older whiskey.
Now I'm lying here.
Conway Twitty.
With Linda.
Those are some great hits. You get 50 in all. Every one a top country hit performed by the original country stars. 50 original country hits can be delivered right to your home, so call now.
I'll get the blanket from the bedroom.
Billy Joe's
Chair. Down in Louisiana.
Bobby Bear.
Where black trees grow.
50 original country hits on three giant stereo records or two stereo 8-track or cassette tapes. All for only $14.98. Here's how to order.
COD and credit card customers call toll-free 1-800-257-1234. In New Jersey, call 800-232-6966. Or save COD fees by sending $14.98 prepaid orders at $1 for shipping and handling to 50 original country hits. Box 7500, Atlanta, Georgia. Please allow 4 to 6 weeks for delivery.
There's the bell as Ray Stevens moves out against Mike Jackson. This should be quite a test for both men. Jackson, slightly smaller of the two, exceptionally fast, but Stevens allowed him no opportunity. Caught him right on the break. And it's Stevens now with a forearm, now a hard right hand to the side of the jaw. And Jackson fires back, and man, did Jackson explode on Ray Stevens. And Stevens caught coming off those ropes, and Jackson catches him again. Mike Jackson proving that he can be every bit as volatile as Ray Stevens in this particular instance. Jackson, who has his master's degree, also a basketball coach. He's quite an athlete, all-around athlete. Stevens is a guy who has been called the man who can do it all. He's from riding Brahma bulls to wrestling to racing motorcycles. The man is just... an absolutely fearless competitor. But it's Jackson right now with a side headlock on Ray Stevens. Stevens will run the emotional fence, and now having his hands full here with Mike Jackson as Jackson is clamped down. Now off the ropes, Jackson catches him, a good shoulder smash. Off the ropes once again, and that time it was Stevens. One step ahead, but Jackson breaks him up once again. Jackson has a full body slam on Ray Stevens. Into a hip lock takedown by Jackson. Now Jackson back with the side headlock. Jackson keeps applying the pressure to Ray Stevens. Stevens now will be trying to figure, number one, an escape from the side headlock, then what counter move he is going to attempt, and then what happens if Jackson blocks him. Right, gets him fired up and caught him with a knee. Stepped to one side and drove a knee to the midsection of Mike Jackson. And that's the thing, of course, that you have to watch for with Stevens. He is an extremely resourceful competitor. Good move by Jackson. Put him in a vertical cross body block. Stevens powered out before the shoulders were down for the count of three, however. That's the thing about Jackson. He will move and he will carry the battle to you. Keeping the side headlock, so Ray Stevens, with a handful of problems here. Interesting to see what approach Stevens does take if and when he gets out of this side headlock. Nope, Stevens took him to the ring ropes, changing his strategy. Under the arm that time on the break and then using the elbow very effectively. Jackson now smashed into that turnbuckle and staggered. And it is Stevens closing in on him once again. Again, Jackson smashed. And now Jackson to the midsection, but that one did not have authority, and now it is Stevens pressing the advantage on Mike Jackson. Stevens, and you could hear Jackson possibly saying that Stevens took some extra leverage that time. And that is not surprising. And now Jackson using the elbow effectively to the midsection. Referee watching carefully and warning Stevens about his actions. Jackson slips away, gets him into a hammerlock. Clamps down. Stevens now with some hard right hands that has Jackson in trouble, and Stevens now with a forearm to the side of the jaw. And so Jackson, checking that time, could have a broken nose. I'm not sure as Jackson gets set and ready, moves up for a beautiful flying head scissors. Mike Jackson in the air catches Stevens with a flying drop kick, and Stevens is down. Jackson tried to pin his man Stevens, came away from it, however, before the count of three, off the ropes, and that time as Jackson went up, Stevens grabbed hold of that rope, held himself short. Jackson came down on the back of his head. Full body slam by Stevens once again. Lateral press. Jackson out before the count of three. Stevens closes in on him once again. Brings him up. Atomic knee drop. It is all over. It is all over for Mike Jackson as Ray Stevens, hard pressed, managed to get the atomic knee drop and delivered it very effectively to Mike Jackson and scored the count of 1, 2, 3. As you can see right here, bringing him up for the atomic knee drop. Notice the high set, the high arch. Came down on the upper part of the thigh. Solid contact. The vertebrae is jarred. Jackson is stunned. He has him in close, cinched up, and the count of three. Wrestling will be held tomorrow night in Marietta, Georgia, at the Cobb County Civic Center. This coming Tuesday night in Adairsville, Georgia. Thursday night, wrestling comes to Gadsden, Alabama. And, of course, on Friday night, to Gainesville, Georgia. And, of course, great matches upcoming at the Omni on June 6th. We'll tell you all the information next week.
About right here is Columbus, Ohio, Huntington, Ohio, Pandemonium, the Wrath and Fury. A bus sawyer's coming. Kevin Sullivan, Columbus, Ohio. The tide's turned. The time's come. You're going down because I got the confidence, baby. And let me tell you another thing. Tommy Rich, walking strut. You can beat my hair any way you want. Because the way I see it, broken arm or no broken arm. Huntington, West Virginia, you're mine. 1, 2, 3.
Here's a word. Georgia Championship Wrestling is coming your way to Huntington, West Virginia, Saturday, May 29th. Match time is 8:30 p.m. In the Memorial Field House, you'll see such outstanding stars as Tommy Wildfire Rich, Michael Hayes, and many, many more. And then on Sunday, May 30th, 8 p.m., in Columbus, Ohio, at the Ohio Civic Center, you'll see Ole Anderson, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, Roddy Piper, and many more. And then Monday, June 7th, in Dayton, Ohio, at the Hera Arena. Tuesday, June 8th, in Canton, Ohio, at the Civic Center. Wednesday, June 9th, in Logan, West Virginia, at the Logan Field House. On Thursday, June 10th, Marion, Ohio, at the Veterans Memorial Coliseum. On Friday, June 11th, in Charleston, West Virginia, at the Civic Center. Remember, tickets are now available for the matches Saturday, May 29th, in Huntington, West Virginia, and Sunday, May 30th, 8 p.m., in Ohio, at the Ohio Civic Center in Columbus. We'll see you. Georgia Championship Wrestling on tour and coming your way. Well, the challenges are flying fast and furious after the National Tag Team Champions, Big John Studd and the Super Destroyer.
You know, we're going to be traveling up north to Huntington, West Virginia, Columbus, Ohio, Dayton, Ohio, and a few other cities. And all the rednecks up there, all the farmers and all the people that work in the office buildings, they're going to come out and they're going to look at us. They're impressed with size. You know, that's Big Ten country, and they're used to seeing big ball players. Well, I'm bigger than any ball player that ever put on a football uniform or a football helmet, and I'm twice as strong and twice as mean.
You know, people have been out here spouting off Leroy Brown, Bob Armstrong, and everybody saying, the two of us can be beat. We might be able to, but you guys are not going to do it, so come out and give it your best shot.
Nashville Alive welcomes co-host Con Hunley. Also appearing, Judy Wells, Diane Pfeiffer, and the Wilburn Brothers. Nashville Alive, tonight on Superstation WTBS.
It began with the ravings of a madman, and it ended with The World at War. See The World at War tonight at 11:05 on WTBS.
Sunday morning, the movie you don't just watch, you live.
What'll I do when you are far away?
And Dean Jones, Under the Yum Yum Tree, Monday night on Superstation WTBS.
Let's take a quick look right now at the great Samoans in action. We'll join this match in progress.
Ernie Land, his mystery partner, the Junkyard Dog, Mr. Olympia. Iron Mike and Buddy Landell are giving him a rough go right now. And Iron Mike, that shoulder power, tremendous leg strength. Once too often, you never, never repeat a move. When you're in there with professionals, you can't do it. You gotta vary your attack. You're just too smart, you're too experienced. You're at it too often. You go with the same move again, week when Coco Samoa hit Bob Root that great move, then he repeated the move later, and Bob Root gave him a belly-to-belly suplex and pinned him right out of the move. You can't make a mistake against these guys. Buddy Landell over the top and in. Iron Mike tagging out. Landell going in against Big Sika. Drop kick. Sika got out of the way. Again, you can't repeat. Sika sailing him in. Clothesline. Landell ducked it. Landell ducked it. Whoa! Offa caught him from outside. Offa caught him with a clothesline from outside. And Sika, that's that brother. That's that team. That's a year and living together and wrestling together. They know everybody, each other's moves.
They caught them, a hand being raised. Offa and Sika there to join in the jubilation. Their manager and advisor, General Skandar Akbar.
Want to take a couple of closing moments right now to talk to Bad Bad Leroy Brown. Twice now, he has put Ric Flair down in arm wrestling.
And that's a bar! Two pounds, baby! Hey, defeat! I hope you learn to like the taste of defeat, big fellow, because your day is coming. Gordon, you know, I told you one time, I said, you know, Georgia is becoming a jungle. You know, I saw the big super dark star, Super Destroyer. Hey, tag team, they lost right in the middle. But Gordon, you know, I'm going to tell you something. The big fellas, you know, there's going to be a lot of changes going on right here. It ain't going to be long coming. Tommy, I talked to Tommy just a while ago, and I told him, I said, Tommy, there's nothing wrong with getting knocked down. But, brother, you got to get back up. You know, Piper talks a lot, and he says a lot of things, but one thing he did say that's very true, Gordon. I didn't become the world champion. And now I'm at a crossroad where I'm going to have to get up and go.
See you next week.
The announcers on this program are employed by Georgia Championship Wrestling Incorporated.